What is up, guys? I am Exotic Gaming, and today I am back with another Minecraft episode on a game that is indeed very fun. If you guys remember last episode, I asked you guys if you would like to see some of my older worlds in my next episode. That's why I am starting this off on my title screen and I'm not actually playing the game right now. That is because I am going to show you guys one of my oldest worlds in this episode today. Something by the name of, as you guys can see here, Mega Cityopolis. I created this world back in September of 2011 and I had not played it since about January of 2013. And I created it even before my oldest world that actually shows up right here, December 6, 2011, because I actually played it into and past 2011, because I liked it so much that I played it a lot more than I did this one here named Sears Tower. I'm going to do this type of series in a two-video process here. This video will actually consist of me showing this world, Mega Cityopolis, and then the next video that I'm going to be doing on Minecraft will show this world, Kamikaze 2.0. Both of them are equally awesome, and I hope you guys are going to enjoy this. So, what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to jump into Mega Cityopolis, and it's a very, very interesting world here. It's very, very interesting. So, basically, my whole premise on creating this world, I figured that out later on when I was actually just exploring this before this video began, was I wanted to create this as a server in Minecraft. I wanted to make this like a whole server type thing, and that's why I have a bunch of signs written down saying things that you would not normally see in a single player world, but I wanted to change this to a server eventually. Never really came to actually truth, but, you know, I wanted that, and that was just my vision in my Minecraft world, but, you know, never actually came out because, you know, come on, making a server is really difficult in Minecraft. So, basically, you would have spawned right here, and when you look up for the first time, it says, "Welcome to Michaelcraft," because Michael is my name, and as you guys can see here, I made this really cool little entrance here inside an amazing looking stone brick pyramid, and there's the water here flowing all symmetrical on all four sides with the lava inside the middle here, and I just thought that looked so cool. So when you first walked out here, you will see that it is a pretty cool looking pyramid here. As you guys can see here, it's lined with glowstone and redstone. For some reason, some of the redstone is not appearing lit up, which is a little interesting. But let's go show you guys all of the buildings that I have built here. There are slimes here, which are very annoying, and I'm going to remove them so they do not cause any trouble. I built this little thing here. This was one of the very first things that I built. This little lily pad pond area, just for people, you know, chill out, hang out, you know. If you're just kind of talking with your friends and you don't want to just talk inside, you know, the boring walkway area, you could talk inside the lily pad area. It just looks so much cooler. And also here, I just thought this looked cool the way I built this with all of the little tracks and, you know, just random bricks all lining the area. And I just thought that looked really, really cool. So I hope you guys think that looks cool, because basically this world pretty much began my whole interest with Minecraft. If I did not have this world, I might not be doing this series for you guys today. You know, even though I kind of stopped building in this world several years ago, this whole interest in Minecraft began when I was playing this world. Because, you know, when I first started building these things, I didn't know if I would like this game. I didn't know if I would even play it 10 days after I began. But as you guys can see, I'm still playing it 4 years after I began. So yeah, as you guys can see back here, I built this really awesome diamond and glass tower with some beds at the top here. You know, you can watch the sunset with this if you wanted to. This is basically a model, a very, very large model of what I built in my Minecraft Pocket Edition world before I raged and deleted the game. I had built the world over a course of, oh, come on, slime, don't crawl up on top of there. God dang it, slime. I had basically built my Minecraft Pocket Edition world over the course of about 2 years, and I had built an insanely huge city about 5 times the size of this or bigger. I mean, it basically, you know how Minecraft Pocket Edition originally had only a limited size for worlds? It covered up almost the entire world of just a city with buildings almost as tall as that. And they were all wooden, they all looked kind of like this, except just super tall. They were super awesome. But then when the update came where fire actually burnt the wood, where lava burnt the wood, even though it was really far away, all of my buildings burnt down, so I decided that it was not worth trying to salvage, and I deleted the game, so, yeah. Anyways, continuing on here, I have my zoo here. I had originally placed squids here, but unfortunately they died. I have no ideas, the reason why, but continuing on here, as you guys can see here, I have my sheep here, my black sheep and my white sheep. And I got nothing over there. I think probably because they probably all died. I got my chickens and my pigs and my cows and everything right here. Come again soon. Oh, thanks so much, man. I appreciate that. yeah, I had some interesting signs here. And especially in the next video that I'm going to be doing, showing you guys the Otherworld Kamikaze 2.0. My God, I had some weird signs written there. Zombie, I see you guys right over there. But anyways, this here is my Netherworld. When I was first playing this, unfortunately, the portal was not actually, you know, lit up like this. So when I do eventually go into the Nether to show you guys what I built, I'm going to have to, you know, explore a bit before I actually can make it back to my house. So it says, bring one minecart to the Nether with you. That is because originally the other nether portal was glitched up and it would spawn you way, as you guys can see here, that's my little minecart track, and it would spawn you way, way away over there. So you would have to just, you know, take a minecart so you could actually get there quicker. Beacons. I built all these beacons when I first figured out beacons were actually in the game, and I made this little walkway. Hold on a second, I hear an Enderman, that's weird. But basically, this is kind of like my little rainbow house. No idea why I built this, but yeah, I built it. And then, continuing on here, as you guys will see, I built this little walkway over to a little park, and I just thought this was really cool. I actually showed this built to my grandma, this little park area, and she thought it looked really, really cool. And she kind of actually figured out finally what Minecraft basically was when I first showed her this back like 3 years ago or such. And yeah, so that's my little walkway to the park. And continuing on with this awesome world here, we are going to go over to this little mossy cobblestone area. It's just another random pyramid. It's not even, oh, that would make me so mad. So mad if I was building this nowadays. It's not even. But yeah, I made this as a little enchantment room, which was pretty cool. And then continuing on here, we have a little walkway that will take us to a, oh, hey, what's this? Oh, ooh, firework rocket. Oh, that's so cool. I remember when fireworks began, like they came in Minecraft. That was really, really cool. I made a bunch of fireworks and I set them off when it was like the 4th of July in my Minecraft world. Because yeah, that's what I did. That is what I did in Minecraft, okay? Don't judge me. Don't judge me. But this is basically like my little hotel here. Got a little, you know, water area with some glass viewing. I have no idea why. Maybe I wanted this to be fish or something. Please leave all tools in these chests. Thank you. Oh my gosh. All lined up with as much stuff as you can find. And, yeah, it says please leave all weapons in these chests. Oh, I guess I didn't put any weapons there. Good thing, though, because probably somebody would have stolen them if they went to this hotel. We have a receptionist here. I actually originally wanted to put, like, a zombie head or something here to be the receptionist, but obviously it didn't really work out too well because it wouldn't have looked kind of real. This little thing here is the AFK ride. So basically, if I had ever made this a server, you know, servers kick people off if they are standing idle for like 10 minutes or so. So basically, I figured this out, or I found out about this with the server that I originally had played on, which was called Waffle Minecraft. And if you just sit in this area, it'll keep moving around so you don't get kicked off the server for being standing still too long. So that's a pretty cool little thing that I built there. Probably a lot of you guys already know what that is. This is the kitchen. As you guys can see here, this is where you cook all the amazing and delicious cakes that are right here at the table. As you guys can see, people have no leg room, which is a very big problem. You know, they just kind of sit, they sit up on top of the back of the chair. Yeah, that's what they do. They don't need to put their legs underneath the table. They put their legs on the table. This is the tennis court. Made a little ladder up to the tennis court. It's like those rooftop tennis courts you see in several hotels over the world. This big, huge thing here, you guys might be a little curious as to what this basically is. Well, when the Freedom Tower was completed, or right before it was completed, the building in New York, which is 1,776 feet tall and is the new tallest building in the U.S., basically, I really, really wanted to build this in Minecraft, because I had not seen anybody build the Freedom Tower yet in Minecraft, and with the one I did see, the only video I did see, was kind of bad looking. It had water running down the sides and stuff, but I wanted to make it like a really huge build, and I did this all literally block by block. I didn't even know what is it called, MC Edit. I didn't even know what that was at the time. I literally built this all block by block, evenly symmetrical across all of the sides. And I never really was able to complete this because I soon realized that this was way, way too big of a replica scale. The scale-to-scale model would make this insanely large. Like, already this would probably be about 100 feet high. And this is literally like the first 15th of the building when I had looked at a picture and tried to build it from the picture. So I stopped building it after about, you know, 4 straight weeks of builds. And there is a skeleton. Don't do it! Don't jump! You have too much to live for, skeleton. But anyways, yeah, I might eventually continue on with this and make this into like a stadium or something. I think this could look like a stadium. I don't know. That's the first thing that came to mind when I stopped building it. Kind of like a stadium or something. But yeah, this was the little railway that I had built to the other ending of the nether portal, which was right about right here. If it loads up. Hello? Oh, yeah, it's right over right there. So I'm not going to obviously go into there because that nether portal is also screwed up, just like the other one. This was a very annoying little contraption I built when I decided to, you know, make a infinite piston thing, killing a cow or something like that. I have no idea why I did that, but yeah, that's what I decided to build. I was a very violent child back in my days of Minecraft. I made a melon farm and a wheat farm. I was a terrible builder at a melon farm because, as you guys can see here, I didn't build it the right way, and most of those melons did not actually get built. Random pig with a saddle and a... What's up, pig? How you doing? I'm gonna make bacon out of you if you keep looking at me like that. All right, basically, I have no idea what this is. Sorry, but too many pigs were spawning. Smiley face. Fantastic. I love the sense of happiness, guys. All right, I love the sense of happiness. Basically, what this is here is this is one of those mob spawners, those mob drops. So, you know, if I ever want to get an easy ender eye or maybe something like a creeper gunpowder to make TNT or stuff, I just go up here. And unfortunately, no mobs are spawned up here because I am in creative mode. But they will just eventually start falling down. And yeah, I'll get some easy XP and stuff from that. This is my amazing parkour course. I built this. This was one of the last things I built in this world before I stopped. Because as you guys remember, I told you about that Waffle Minecraft server. I wanted to build parkour because that server originally had a parkour map. And I love parkour in Minecraft. Well, I haven't really done parkour in Minecraft in a very long time, but I used to love parkour in Minecraft. I always had that sense where, you know, I saw like 3 blocks of lava. I was just like, hey, dude, hold my beer. I'm gonna try to see if I can jump that or something like that to that effect. So yeah, that's the reason why I always just had that daring sense in Minecraft. What's up, witch? God, there's a lot of mobs right here. There's a lot of mobs. So yeah, as you guys can see, it's just like a standard little parkour course. And at the edge, you have the most amazing set of rewards here. You have 64 completely filled. I have every single chest filled with items. All 64 as a reward. So if I had originally made this a server, you know, if you complete the parkour course, you can get whatever item you want. And it is so freaking cool. Magma cream, glistering melons, blaze powder. Oh my gosh, all these things. I've never even seen some of these things in survival mode. Like, I've never seen a glistering melon, never seen magma cream. Yeah, so basically a lot of stuff you could win by doing that. And I thought this looked really cool with the lava going over the edges, completely symmetrical on all of the sides, and not even harming anything at all. I just thought that looked so, so cool. And I built these vines coming from the top down there, and as you guys can see how long it took for them to grow all the way down. I have a bunch of pumpkins right here, and I have some carrots that are seeming to be being destroyed now, which is a little unfortunate. As you guys will see here, I have my very first Minecraft roller coaster that I ever built. Yes, my very first roller coaster. As you guys will see here, that's the exit. I just went inside the exit because I'm a noob. So if I want to go get myself a minecart real quick, what I am going to do is I'm going to place that minecart right here, and I'll show you guys my amazing roller coaster that I did build. I don't know why I decided to build this with pink, purple, and blue, but that's what I decided to do. I thought this was really cool because I had never built a Minecraft roller coaster before, and for a first one, I think this is pretty good. It's not the best, but it looks somewhat realistic. I don't know. Maybe somebody just wants to make the most bright roller coaster you could ever find in Minecraft, so that's what I decided to do. That's what I decided to do. That was some results of some... Yeah, that was a result of some TNT over there, I believe. So, TNT explosions can cause some destructive areas inside your Minecraft world. That looks ugly. I'm gonna have to patch that up. I don't want that. This here, you guys might have already seen that. That was a little spoiler. A failed creeper. Failed Creeper. All in caps locks, because that's how failed it was. Not really. I thought it was pretty good. I think it's pretty good now, now that I come back to this. As you guys can see, it's a very happy-looking creeper. He's like, hi, I'm going to blow you up. We have water. We have red flowers. We have yellow flowers. And we have grass and glass. So we have everything that we need right here. I just thought this looked really, really cool when I built this. This is when I always like to experiment with lava to see what I could build. I always would love to use lava and build things with it. We got a brewery right here. This literally looks like the freaking King's Throne right here with creeper sandstone. And this is not the actual brewery. The brewery is on the second floor with a glass floor up here. We have everything that you could possibly want inside the brewery, brewing stands. And we have everything that we want to put inside here. Feel free to place brewed items in our storage chests. Well, that's fantastic. Probably should have made those ender chests so nobody else would have taken them. Because if this was a server, obviously somebody would want to take them. And yeah, so that's the brewery. We have it lined with redstone. This here is very interesting. Probably something you guys might have not seen before. What do you do when you're a failure and have nowhere to go? Ride the short roller coaster to death. Go on. So, yeah, I made this a roller coaster to death. So if you were a Minecraft player and say your whole house got exploded by a creeper and you were just like, life is not worth living anymore. You put your minecart here, you saw the last little parts of life with the trees and stuff. Looks all nice. It says bye, smiley face, bye. And yeah, it was pretty interesting. So that's pretty much what happens. You fall out through the bottom of the world and you die. I just love this sign that I created back then. Bye! Yeah, you're gonna have a great time when you're dead, yeah. So that was my idea of a fun little roller coaster to death. And then, this is the last part here, just my little end world here. I'm obviously not going to go into the end just because I did not build anything in the end. I did build a bunch of stuff in the nether, though, because that is what I'm going to show you guys last. My amazing nether builds that I made in my world. It says, bring one minecart to the nether with you. That was before the world, for some reason, got a little messed up. And as you guys as I showed you guys before, that was where the nether portal would leave you out. And, yeah, for some reason, when I replaced the fire, whatever it's called, freaking fire and iron, what is this called? Hold on. Let me figure this out. Hold on a second. The flaming flame of fire and, flint and steel. So, when I use the flint and steel again, it spawns me right here. But I did figure out where my house was. You know, we're gonna just kind of quickly move our way this way. And eventually, we will make it to the outside world in just a second. Hold on just a dying second. We're almost there. We are almost there. So what I decided to do is I decided to... What did I decide to do? Hold on. Where am I? Hello? Where am I? I went just up from right here. And yeah, so this basically, if I can figure out where my beacons are... Hold on just a second. Hello, Ghast. How are you doing? I hope you're doing well. If I can find where my beacons are, they will lead me back to my world. I think they're this way, possibly, maybe. I hope they are. Hello, beacons? Beacons, where are you? Come on. I figured this out before. I should be able to figure this out now. Dang it. Yeah, dang it. Where's my beacon? Oh! Oh, hey. There's another fortress. I got a little excited. I thought that was what I built. No. That was already there. But my beacons, I think, are this way. So I'll show you guys this in just a dying second. Just the one second. If I can figure this one out. Where's my beacon? Beacon. Come on. I think they're this way. Yes, they are this way. All right. So we will figure this out together. We are going to figure out where the beacon leads us. And it will lead us to the entrance to the amazing Minecraft world. Which is, I believe, this way. Hello? Hello, server. Are you gonna go let me go to my Minecraft world? I hope you are. It's this way. Yep, it's definitely this way. Okay. Hello? Hello? Yep, it's right here. Yes, here we go, guys. There we go. Little bit of a delay there, but... yeah, so this is basically... if the pig would ever want to go, you know, visit, they're going to take this amazing beacon bridge. And I thought that just looked super, super cool with the cobblestone, the way it was kind of leaned out into the water there. And you got a good view of all the lava and stuff. And basically, Pigman, you're gonna have to move out of the way, alright? I do not want you coming in, alright? Yeah. Yeah, you don't wanna go inside here. You gonna get a lot of destruction towards you if you ever go in here. Basically, this was where the nether portal would have let you off. Go to other end of bridge to build. Fantastic. So if I have ever continued on with this build, I would have built more at the end of the bridge. But this is basically kind of where the hotel type thing is. I don't know. I never really... No, actually, the hotel is that way. This is kind of where you eventually begin when you get into the nether first off, as you guys can see. It looks really, really cool with all the ender chests and enchantment tables and furnaces and crafting tables and all this stuff. This is very interesting here. The Sacred Butter Temple, made specifically for Skydas Minecraft. Yes, this was when I avidly watched Skydas Minecraft, who used to be my most favorite YouTuber, probably after... like Smosh and a couple other guys, but yeah, that shows how long ago when I used to watch Skydas Minecraft literally every single day. I don't watch him now anymore, but that was when I did. And this is another bridge area, and as you guys can see, I don't know what this looks like. This looks like one of the, like a helmet from some old video game. Pigman, get yourself off the bridge right now. You're not welcome. Okay. But this is probably the coolest thing I've ever built in Minecraft. Probably not ever, but this is a really, really cool thing. As you guys can see, this is the walkway to death. Not really death, because obviously, well, I mean, technically kind of death. But as you guys can see, it's a really, really cool walkway. The lava flows down through the whole walkway. I mean, it's all lava. It's all lava. And basically, once you get down to the bottom here, you'll see that there's some brick and some weird things, you know? It just looks a little interesting. Have some wood, and it actually is not burning, so that's awesome. And this is why I say it's the walkway to death. This is the amazing little gladiator room, I guess you could say what this is. So say you want to do like a really cool PvP type thing in the server in the nether. You would come over to right here. It says the rules. I can't spell, obviously. Number one, do not break blocks. So, you know, obviously you wouldn't want to break the blocks because there's lava above. And then only use your own sword. If found, turn in opponent's sword. Swords are turned in the chests by the front. Do not attack onlookers. That's probably a good idea. I think the onlookers would probably kind of just hang out right up here if they're super small. Where would the onlookers look? Oh, they probably sit there and that's where, like, the coach of the gladiator guys would fight. I figure that would be cool. Yeah. And then what's the last rule? Make sure to be careful. Well, I mean, you're fighting to the death, so I don't think that's really a problem. This is where the swords are. I don't know why you would need to turn in the opponent's sword if the swords are already there. I guess maybe you want to bring your own. You would place them right here in this chest. But as you guys can see here, this is my nether hotel. As you guys can see here, I built this and you basically have a ton of rooms. Obviously, these are the less expensive ones because there's just lava with your view. But going upwards, as you guys can see, it's the exact same thing for like four floors. And then eventually, this is where you get up to some of the more expensive rooms, because now you can actually kind of see outside. And then this is the most expensive room, because you can actually have a really good view of the whole area outside your windows. And I even decided to make this... Pigman, what are you doing? Get out! God dang it, Pigman. How are they inside? Alright, we're gonna have to, we're going to destroy these guys real quick. Goodbye. Goodbye. Bye-bye. Bye-bye. You're done. You are done. Alright, perfect. Now, no. No! Do not go inside. Do not go inside. It is the hotel. Remember to close the door. Well, I guess I didn't close the door before I was doing this because all the pigmen got it. Pigmen got in. But I decided to make this kind of like home. Yeah. I even made the trees symmetrical, as you guys can see there. You know? How awesome is that to have symmetrical trees? And yeah, so that's basically it, guys. That is pretty much it for the first part of me showing you guys everything that I built in my whole Minecraft world. This is my very first Minecraft world that I avidly built stuff in. As you guys remember, I created this back in September of 2011. Almost 4 years ago now. It's now 2015, mid-August 2015. So it's been a long time. So I hope you guys did enjoy this video. If you guys did, then be sure to hit that like button, comment, favorites, and subscribe for some more Minecraft PC Survival Series Edition episodes. Besides the next episode that I'm going to be doing, all the ones before this were all on a survival world that I've been on for about almost a year now in series. So if you guys, this is the first one you've seen, then you might want to check out my series because they are very funny and you guys might really like them. So yeah, thank you all for watching, and I will see you all in the next episode, which will be a whole little see-through walkthrough, not walkthrough, what? That's not the right word. Basically, a whole little tour of my next world, which will be Kamikaze 2.0. So yeah, thank you all for watching. See you all in the next episode.